guide, we will follow.
Hi, welcome to Trinity Talk Live, water cooler conversation from a Christian perspective. This episode today, we're going to focus on our music ministry here at Trinity Lutheran Church. My name is Ryan McAllister. I'm the director of music. Really happy to be in this position. And to my left is the wonderful Phil Noske. I'll let him introduce himself as well.
My name is Phil Noske. I'm the assistant director of contemporary music here at Trinity. My role is just to kind of take some of the burden off Ryan as he's helping both with traditional and contemporary. I lead the youth band and just kind of help out wherever is needed.
Right. He's very helpful. You won't see Brad today. Brad Detweiler is our organist and the traditional assistant music director. He does a lot with our choirs as well, adults and accompanies, and plays the organ. He's a jack of all trades. Then a little later, you'll also see Jessica McAllister, who is in charge of all of our children's music. So the first thing we're going to look at here is actually this entire episode is going to be a survey of music throughout our ministry here at Trinity, and we're going to look at both contemporary, traditional, and then also our children's music ministry. So we're going to begin with our traditional music ministry and our adult choir. The choir, as it's an adult choir, it's for adults, middle school and above, and it's mainly adults who are out of school. And we sing for our 9:27 traditional service every Sunday, with a few exceptions when the children might sing or for special occasions. We like to sing hymns that are accompanied or unaccompanied, anthems, and sometimes we have fun accompaniment with either the organ, piano, or string quartet, or brass. We like to change it up. So this is our traditional choir, and the first thing you're going to see is one of our anthems from our Sunday service.
Thank you.
Our next ensemble, we're calling the Trinity Chorale. And this is something that we really just started this last year. Those of you who may not be from this church, but maybe you're have a choral program somewhere else, you may have the challenge of finding people who can be there every week, who can rehearse every week, who can sing every week. So we're trying to create an opportunity for those who love to sing choral music, but can't be there to rehearse every single week and sing on Sunday. So what we're doing is once a month, we've chosen some songs that really do well with larger numbers, maybe more challenging, but also they may have more splits and to stylistically have some variation. We've done some gospel pieces as well as some just great sacral choral songs as well. So we meet on a Thursday night for our rehearsal just once a month, and then we'll sing on that following Sunday. And so far we've had a really good response, and folks are excited about it, and it's a more manageable commitment for them. And you know, we give them the songs way ahead of time. They know when the rehearsals will be, and it's been really, really fun. So you're going to see one of those songs coming up next. And just paired with that is something we also do, are called our seasonal singers, who sing for Christmas Eve, for Easter, and for our God and Country service. And that's even a smaller commitment, but they're big festive services where sometimes we have college folks who are back in town or people traveling, and they want to be connected and sing in worship, but they can't be here every week or even once a month. That's kind of our third option. So we're excited about these different options. And if this strikes a chord with you and would like to sing either with the chorale or with seasonal singers, please contact me. We'd love to have you. So enjoy.
Who'll be a witness for my Lord? Who'll be a witness for my Lord? Who'll be a witness for my Lord? Who'll be a witness for my Lord?
Oh, I'll be a witness for my Lord. I'll be a witness for my Lord. I'll be a witness for my Lord. Lord, I'll be a witness for my Lord. There was a man of the Pharisees. His name was Nicodemus, and he didn't believe. The same came to Christ by night, wanted to be taught out of human sight. Demas was a man who desired to know how a man can be born when he is old. Christ told Nicodemus as a friend,
man, you must be born again.
He said, marvel not, be wise, repent,
believe, and be baptized.
Then you'll be a witness for my Lord. You'll be a witness for my Lord.
About Samson's strength was never found out, till his wife sat upon his knee.
She said, tell me where your strength lies, if you please.
Well, old Samson's wife, she talked so fair. Samson said,
cut off my head,
cut it off
my head, just as clean as your hand, and my strength will come like a natural man.
Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. Saul is a witness for my Lord. There's another witness.
There's another witness.
There's another witness.
There's another witness
for my Lord. My soul.
Okay, this next ensemble is our Trinity Ringers. That's our adult handbell choir. We rehearse weekly throughout the year, and we like to play for some special services as well. We play for one of the Advent services, one of our Lenten Wednesday services as well. And sometimes we'll augment the orchestra or choir with the organ as well and play some combined pieces. So it's a really fun choir. We do play challenging music of different styles, and we do have folks that sub in and out. It's really important in handbells, if you don't know, to have every bell covered, or else you'll lose the melody or you'll lose the chord at times. So there's a big commitment that comes with handbells, but it really is a lot of fun. We take breaks during the summer and other times. So don't let that discourage you if you're interested in our handbell choir or somewhere else. It's really fun, and it's challenging in a way of really reading music, playing together as a group, and really, I think, improves musicality.
Yeah, and one of the things that I really enjoy about the handbells is just hearing all of the different parts. You know, you can hear a song that you're familiar with, you can hear the melody, you hear harmonies, you hear everything just without the words, and it's actually a really beautiful way to worship, a really beautiful style to worship. And as far as being able to read the music, if that's something that you struggle with handbells, most of the time you really only need to know two notes. So it's actually a surprisingly easy way to get yourself started in that path of learning how to read sheet music and getting more involved with the ministry, the music ministries here at Trinity.
Our next ensemble is our Trinity Orchestra, and we'll also lump into this some of our seasonal instrumentalists that we have from week to week. But what you're going to see is our large Trinity Orchestra playing for our God and Country service, and this is comprised of some volunteers from the community and from our church, and there are also some paid professionals who play as well, so we can really fill out the orchestra and have all the parts covered. It's really, really fun. The music can be moderate to challenging depending on the service and the year, but there are definitely parts for everyone who is maybe not a novice, but is comfortable on their instrument. So it's really fun. It adds so much to worship, and we try to have that full orchestra for Christmas, Easter, God and Country, and occasionally we'll have it for some other big Reformation services or other special celebrations throughout the year. So if you're interested in this, we'd love to have you join us. This is something we plan very far out in advance, so we make sure that we have everything covered, especially since we need to hire some of our musicians. So enjoy this festive song from our God and Country service.
Hi, everybody. My name is Jessica McAllister. I am the director of the children's choirs here at Trinity. Wanted to share with you a little bit about what children's choir is and what it looks like. We have a mission in children's choir, and the mission for our ministry is to learn and declare the truth of the gospel of Jesus Christ within a fun, engaging, meaningful experience. We have two choirs, one of younger children starting at age about 3 years old to grade one. They are called Joyful Noise, and our older choir is Joyful Sounds, and that ranges from grade two to grade five. In both choirs, we emphasize growing in your musical knowledge, both vocally and instrumentally. Our little ones enjoy instruments that are fun to use and shake and make sounds, along with a lot of singing together. Our older choir focuses also on learning handbells and introducing that concept, along with growing in their musical knowledge vocally and instrumentally. Our children's choirs perform about once a month in worship in the different services. They're involved in the children's pageant, and they also participate in some community events throughout the year. It is a wonderful time for the children to grow in their spirituality, understand biblical themes and concepts through the songs that we choose, and to grow in their relationships with each other. So it's a wonderful ministry, and I am proud to and honored to be a part of it. So we hope you enjoy.
Hello. to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love Him. I just want to lift
All right, this next segment that you're going to see is about our Saturday night worship team. Saturdays are really fun. They're what I wind up leading most Saturdays. And we just kind of take our Sunday worship. We really strip it down. It's really intimate. It's acoustic. And it's an overall great experience. If you don't want the drums, you don't want the crowd that comes on Sundays, Saturday worship is a great option. We're always looking for people to come join. And just if that is something that you're interested in, go ahead and shoot me an email, give Ryan a call, and we'd be more than happy to get you on the schedule for it.
Yeah. And just another note that you'll see, we do use a different space for most of the year for the 507 on Saturday service. We call it Heritage Hall. It was the original sanctuary to the church, and it's a beautiful space. And we also feel like with a smaller crowd, like Phil said, it's a little more intimate. You can really hear people singing. The pastor's down right with you, and it just, things really flow, and there's just a different feel. It's hard to explain. I hope you'll come and enjoy, especially if you can't make Sunday one week. Maybe you're going to be traveling or you have another commitment. Try coming on Saturday. Show up at 5, and you know, it's just an hour of worship, and then we leave, we go home, and on to the evening. So enjoy this clip from our 507 service.
From the ground, we feel it now. Burst.
So this next segment that we're going to be looking at is going to highlight our 11 o'clock contemporary worship service. The 11 o'clock contemporary service happens in our main sanctuary. It's gonna have a full worship band, so it's going to have drums, it's going to have bass. The best way to liken it is if you like listening to contemporary Christian radio, like our local station is Shine FM. If you like listening to Chris Tomlin, David Crowder, Hillsong, we're doing worship more in that style on our 11 o'clock service. But it's still within the Lutheran Church. We practice the doctrine. We commune every week. So it's just a great alternative for those who prefer that style of worship to the traditional worship that you find it at many, many churches, including ours.
Yeah, Phil's saying it well. There can be a lot of baggage connected to contemporary, traditional, emergent, all of those different words. So we try to use celebration service at 11. It is really a worshipful celebration. And it is on the contemporary side, even though I said that maybe we shouldn't use those words. It's our largest worship service, typically from week to week. And we do have a multi-generational worship team, particularly at this service, ranging from middle school all the way up through, I don't know who our oldest is. We probably shouldn't say that because we'll get in trouble. But it's even fun. We have some families who are here, fathers, daughters, and that's really, really fun as well. So it has a different feel than Saturday night. It does, as Phil said, keep what it means to be Lutheran. And that's something that we always kind of walk the line with of how do we remain relevant, but always keep what it means to be Lutheran and Trinity Lutheran. So we hope you enjoy this segment. And if you're having more questions about that in particular, there are lots of services you can see on the YouTube channel where you can see them in their complete form and see how the flow goes. And they're typically all on there from our 11 o'clock. So enjoy.
Pretty sure we have met. Every single day of your life, I'm the whisper inside that won't let you forget. Hello, my name is Ethi. I know you recognize me. Just when you think you can win, I'll drag you right back down again till you've lost all. And I have believed them for the very last time. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. I've been saved, I've been changed, I have been set free. Amazing grace is the song I sing. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. Longer defined by all the wreckage behind. true king. I've been saved, I've been changed, I have been set free. Amazing grace is the song I sing. Hello, my name is child of the one true king. Whoa, 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 whoa. What love, let's sing it out. What love the Father has lavished upon us that we should be called his children. I am a child of the one true King. What love the Father has lavished upon us that we should be called his children.
Now, our final segment is going to highlight one of my favorite groups at the church. It's going to highlight our youth band, Chosen, and why I really love Chosen. I grew up going to the youth group. I was there kind of when Chosen was just kind of having the groundwork laid, and I've watched a lot of the kids that are there now grow up. You know, I've watched a couple of them go all the way from sixth grade, where they were just kind of barely had hands big enough to play a guitar, to now they're in high school or have graduated, and just been able to watch their musical gifts grow, to watch their hearts grow. And it's just, it's really awesome to see kids that still have a love for Jesus, that still want to show, you know, to preach his gospel through their talents, and just have them able to come worship in church. They've played at the Harford County Farm Fair, for those of you who are familiar with that, and it's awesome to watch the kids just worship and sing and praise.
Yeah, I agree with everything Phil is saying, and it was fun to come here 7 years ago and have Phil be a part of it and see him now in a leadership position. It's really cool how God works in that way, and the kids are great. There's lots of things that they do outside in the community, as well as leading for J-Fire, which is our weekly youth gathering, as well as usually either monthly or bi-month, quarterly in worship at 11. And then we have some youth weekends in the winter and in the summer where they do every worship service. And that's something we're really trying to craft moving forward, so they have a good exposure to all the different styles of worship that we do here and can minister to the congregations, because there are a lot of folks who only go to one of the services and they want to be exposed to our great youth musicians.
Faith is dead, I need a rest.
We'd like to thank you so much for watching. And if you like this episode, please click the like button. That's the thumbs up button on the screen. And we'd encourage you to share this video with all of your friends and family, anyone that you think this might be helpful or encouraging to see. And you can also subscribe to our channel. And this channel also has its own Facebook page. It's Trinity Joppa Channel. And next week, a little teaser, we're going to have our favorite Christmas songs from a bunch of different members of the Trinity worship teams and choirs. So I'm going to sing something. Phil's going to sing something. We might sing something together. I don't think there'll be any dancing, but...
There might be. If I bring my wife, she's a dancer.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, that might happen. So just want to thank Phil again for being a part of this. Thank Jessica and Brad, who is not on this, but just do so much for our ministry here. And just want to thank you all for watching. We'll see you next week. God bless.
In your word we will follow.
Hey, if you haven't joined our Patreon yet, would you mind giving it your prayerful consideration? Patreon is a way you can support the Trinity Joppa YouTube channel. We've got multiple tiers to choose from, starting as low as $2 per month. Visit www.patreon.com/Trinity Joppa for all the details. Thank you. God bless.